Government performance in fighting corruption, the trend over time shows that between 20, over time shows that for those who believe the government has performed very or fairly well, declined by 3% between 2002 and 2017, but increased by 35% from 2014 to 2017. So that is the red line. Those who believe corruption, government anti-corruption fight has been very or fairly well in 2002 was 63%. And when you compare it to 2017, it's 60%. So there is just a marginal drop of 3%. But when you look at 2014 to 2017, it moves from 25% to 60%. So an increment of about 35%. And then in contrast, we see the same situation for those who believe government has performed very or fairly badly. Nearly three quarters of Ghanaians strongly agree or agree that government devotes more resources towards investigating and punishing corrupt officials. Close to one-fifth, however, think otherwise. 6 in 10 Ghanaians strongly agree or agree that ordinary people can make a difference in the fight against corruption, as against 53% in 2014. About one-third believe otherwise, compared to 36 who think so in 2014. On reporting incidents of corruption, 61% said they risk retaliation, while 35% said they can do so without fear. So what appropriate punishment will citizens want government to mete out to corrupt persons? As punishment for corrupt officials, majority of Ghanaians, 64%, want corrupt officials prosecuted, jailed, stolen funds retrieved, and named and shamed by government. In fact, when you look at the chart, you will see more of that. The question was direct and we made a statement in terms of the type of naming and shaming that they will want. And the statement was that the stolen money that is retrieved is used to put up a public facility and then the name of that corrupt official written on it, that this public facility was built with stolen money retrieved from so-so and so. And that is what most of Ghanaians went in for. Meaning that corruption has become a problem and now they want people to have a history. Your generations will come and see that business school there with your name written on it, that you stole money and it was retrieved from you. My interest is not in people going for that, but it tells me a lot about what people are thinking about corruption now. It has become a problem, a huge problem, for people to want generations to come and see their grandfathers being named as having stolen money. It tells a lot.